Greetings, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome back to the Azure Seas of Nita. I am der Heizmeister, and this is episode 5 of From the Depths, the Quest for Nita campaign. Now then, I am here in the designer, and the two units that you can see are prototypes. Prototypes I have constructed, and I plan to build and use in the campaign very, very soon. I will not go over the details of what those capabilities of these prototypes are. I would just like to show them to you. Once they are constructed, I will go into more detail. Well, on one hand, we have a rather long and thin ship here, equipped with various weapon systems. And an airship, which I have been building with great input from Razul. This one is was originally meant for my Great Talents campaign, but I guess I'll test it in the Quest for Nita campaign first. And yes, this is one of those, dare I say it, frontsiders. Oh no, I said it. Yeah, it is a frontsider. Yeah, so that's basically it for those prototypes that will be deployed in the campaign fairly soon. And speaking of the campaign, let's get into it, shall we? And here we are, back again in the war room, with a nice view of the map. Now, the situation has changed between the last episode and this one. I have annihilated the Lightning Hood's HQ, the Quartzstone Fortress, in the last episode, and I've now set up a resource transfer route using this giant cargo aircraft. It's called a giant, it's not really giant. Okay, good. Yeah, to ferry resources from this point of the map to my headquarters. Now, anything else that has changed? I have set up various units to capture the remaining terrain tiles. I have left the Lightning Hood installations that remain on the map mostly intact. Yes, even those resource zones, I will deal with them later. Because I have spotted something rather interesting. As you can see here, I have now a very good view on the territory of the White Flayers. And they are currently under attack by the Steel Striders. Now, as much as I would like to see the White Flayers gone from the map, I would like to be the one who does the attacking and the elimination of the White Flayers. So, in this case, I will simply order my units for now to belay the Operation Annihilate the Onyx Watch, which I originally planned. I will now move into White Flayer territory and grab every terrain tile that I can, preferably cutting off the Steel Striders from the resource zone here, and maybe even annihilating the White Flayer HQ in this episode. That means two of the major players of Nita are already out. That is certainly an advantage. Ah, war between the White Flayers and the player. Oh no. Woe is me.
Listening. Moving out.
How unfortunate. Okay, let's see. I want to get over there as soon as possible.
Listening.
In this case,
listening.
My aircraft
moving
need
out
to make best speed to this area.
Moving out. Moving out.
Hurry
moving
a bit, out. Will you? I need this resource zone. And then this one, and this one, and all of this. While I'm at it, I have something new for you. I have constructed something at the home base. And there it is. I have constructed a new airship at my home base. This is the Sol-type missile cruiser. Armed with heavy missiles that are equipped with a mix of EMP, frag, some missiles even are remote guided, and do have heat warheads in them. And yes, those are all large missiles. In fact, those are, if I didn't miss, oh yes, looks like those are 14 large missiles. Furthermore, the Zol missile cruiser is equipped with a modified jackhammer system on the back here, providing Seabiss and anti-air defense, as well as some casemates all around this ship. Those are mostly secondary guns. Some simple weapons for anti-aircraft defense as well as some repurposed frigate turrets that fire HASH projectiles. All in all, a very versatile and devastating airship, and yeah, I hope you'll see it in action soon enough, because I need this one on the front against the White Flayers. And off you go to the front. Yeah, the Zol missile cruiser isn't particularly fast. It is, well, I think its top speed is a little bit over 80 kilometers per hour. No, 80 meters per second. Oh, that's it. Yeah, 85 meters per second. But that is plenty for my purposes. Now, off you go to the front. So, while all of this is going on the map, I am busy constructing a new task force. This will be Task Force Saturn, consisting of a Aegis-class destroyer, a Sregar-class destroyer, a Lancer Corvette, an AV-24 Predators, actually two of them, which have been sent in by I. Persons to replace his a Jaguar helicopter, and a Sirius cruiser, which I built, as well as the battleship Trevorrow, another construction of mine. Yeah, this one will be a supporting force in the war against the Onyx Watch. I will have to reform Task Force Jupiter as soon as they are finished dealing with the White Flayers. And here we have the first units engaging. An Earthraker is engaging this Steel Strider Force, consisting of an Albatross, a Hawk, and a Tiger Shark. This Earthraker will not last very long, I assume. And a Charon is moving towards my forces.
Listening.
Very well, then. Well, my Polaris-class light carrier is being blockaded by this Charon that was approaching me, so I guess I have to answer now. I will deploy the heavy cruiser Arcrux as well as the light carrier in this battle.
Receiving.
Just make sure that you spawn well away from this unit. And I'll be surveying the battlefield from the bridge of the carrier. Let's go. And yep, there we go. Everything spawned in rather nicely. And let's see what we have here. This is the Charon. As you can see, there are some small missile interceptors on there. A missile turret on top. And yes, you are correct. These are a whole lot of small torpedoes. These launchers are tilted so that those torpedoes can be basically thrown overboard, and then they will head on its merry course towards their enemies. And I have a question. Why do almost all of the White Flayer ships have some kind of oversized version of the Nicer Dicer on them? You have been judged lacking. At first. What a mad lad. Anyway, let's do this. Alright, cruiser has spawned in, carrier has spawned in, and is already launching its drones. Oh, it would be launching its drones if I would enable the AI correctly. Okay then, Vector Wings are on their way and heading towards the Charon. And there are the particle accelerator cannons. The Vectors, by the way, they do run out of energy on their own at some point. This is the one of the reasons why I've selected them as carrier fighters. Large torpedoes incoming. The carrier supplies them with energy, as the carrier can generate a lot of energy from its steam turbines. Red missile trails. Interesting. Seems to be a bug, I think. We'll see about that. Anyway, how's the carrier doing? I have registered some impacts. Yeah. That is too much for this little unit. The carrier has unfortunately been hit pretty hard by this torpedo spam coming from the Charon, and there's still more. Yeah. Anyway, let's see how the cruiser is doing. Red smoke particles. Very interesting. Maybe I can give them some support in the form of a Decanus-class torpedo boat. Since my units are struggling a bit with this white flare ship that likes to spam torpedoes. Now, where are the large ones? Oh, there they are. Carrier at 94%. Nothing to worry about. And here are some torpedoes of our own. Impact. Nice. It very well seems that the firepower of this Charon is concentrated towards, well, seaborne targets. As I do not see any anti-aircraft armament on there, well, save for the missile launcher that got shot off very early. So, maybe I should have engaged with a little bit more aircraft in this battle. I'm fairly certain that my aerial torpedo boats would have made short work of this unit. However, let's appreciate the beauty of torpedo spam for now. Even if I am on the receiving end of said spam. Looks like it's the Arcrux's turn to take some damage now. As you can see, those torpedoes won't be easily spoofed by sonar decoys. Although the Arcrux is deploying countermeasures, right now it seems that those torpedoes have signal processors on them, making decoys, well, next to useless actually. Or at least increasing their... no, wait, decreasing their effectiveness. And you have made landfall. Well, that's unfortunate now, isn't it? It would be a shame if you, oh, I don't know, launched your large torpedoes from the bottom launchers and they would impact on your own ship. Looks like I wasn't passive-aggressive enough. This plan did not work. The Charon has taken heavy damage. It is currently venting steam and not looking that well, to be honest. One of its torpedo batteries has been severely damaged, but at least the Nysa Dicer is still fairly intact. Yep, that's some sturdy construction right there. Oh, and there's the Decanus class. Firing missiles and torpedoes. But yeah, guess that's it for the Charon. Battle finished, Charon eliminated, and some damage taken in the process. Alright, now I need to relocate Task Force Jupiter to their assigned duties, which are capturing more terrain tiles. No, sir. You are not here for capturing. Moving out. You are here for scouting. And scouting I will.
Moving out.
What do we fear? An Earthraker, a Deliverance, which is a cargo transfer unit, and a whole bunch of steel striders poised to strike and ready to capture this terrain tile. Where is my air support? On its way. Okay, guess I should be a little bit more patient then. An Earthraker is approaching my forces. Looks like this farming equipment is in for a surprise. Good thing my air force is stationed here, which I haven't named yet. While I'm at it, I will just take out this Fulgrite resource harvester that the Lightning Hoods have set up there. So I don't need to come back for it later. Oh no, you're quite high. You're way too high up there. Actually, yeah, okay then. I'll be on a sort of Sword in the Wind version 3, equipped with cram bombs, I guess. Anyway, let's do this. And all forces deployed. And if I were to deploy any surface vessels against this, I would be in for a very, very bad time. This is the Earthraker, making great use of not only simple weapon drills, but also spin-blocked rams, and they look very, very dangerous. They look like a world of hurt. Hello? Looks like you're being ignored by everyone except some Phoenix Interceptors right there. Yeah. Anyway, looks like the rest of the Air Force is currently engaging the Fulgrite resource zone, or resource harvester. Yeah, let them be. The two Swords of the Wind are coming around for another attack run. And bombs away on the first one, and bombs away on the second one. Good hit on the weapon here. I think this one is disabled. And some EMP strikes from the Phoenix Interceptors, which have dealt with the Earthraker, judging from this resource deposit there. And now all that's left to do is annihilate the Fulgrite, liberate the resource zone, and then probably build a mobile mine to start harvesting operations in this area. Well, wait. The Sword and Wind is transitioning into hover mode. This means that the AI is probably dead on the Fulgrite. AI dead. You can read it just... oh no, now it's too damaged, but it was AI dead. I'm fairly certain of it. Hover mode engaged. Okay then. Next one, please. Looks like I'm in a race against time here. If I want to conquer this resource zone, the Steel Striders are already making great progress. In this direction, eastward. I guess it didn't help that I had to pull out my air force from this tile. No, surely didn't help the capture process, does it? Looks like the Steel Striders are departing for now, leaving a narrow corridor for me to capture. Luckily, however, my oversized air support has arrived.
Moving out.
In the form of the Sol missile cruiser.
Moving out.
Yeah, as soon as an opportunity presents it here, I will.
Listening.
There it is.
Moving out.
Capture it.
Moving out.
Now.
Moving out.
And let's see the Sol missile cruiser in action. Actually, now that I can. Mine. Thank you.
Listening.
There we go. Altitude is correct, and The Deliverance is on land, by the way. Okay. Airship online and fire the missiles. Ah, nice. Yeah, this is a party mix of missiles, as I have mentioned previously. Some of them are remote guided, some of them are infrared guided, and others are radar guided. Every missile for almost every occasion. Okay, what do we have here other than red particles? Oh yeah, it's one of these resource harvesters. This is a flayed monastery. I'm going to assault it. And here we have the Deliverance going out of control. There goes your overseas package and cargo. Very fast though. Well, I guess that's to be expected when you are using four steam propellers. Is this a 5 meter? Yeah, that's a 5 meter version, I think. Anyway, you are dead. Very much so, and the Zonra can not the Zonra, no, that's my other airship. The Sol missile cruiser can now deal with the remaining forces on the battlefield. Although you have dealt with the Deliverance, this should net me a hefty amount of salvage. The Deliverance is worth quite a lot. Actually, you might wanna change target to the Flayed Monastery for now. And don't stray too far into this zone. There is the White Flayer headquarter. The Gorgon is located there. Yeah. Oh, and by the way, if you're wondering why did I set up these casemates here so tucked away and barely able to fire out of this position, they are very much protected and can fire from this angle, as you can clearly see. They can fire out here, down here, down here, maybe not in this direction, but everywhere else. And there goes pretty much every anti-aircraft weapon on this airship. Including the jackhammer. Do we have any missiles in the air? No, not yet. But there we go. Launched a little bit too late. Or maybe too early. The battle has concluded. Good news, everyone! Task Force Saturn, at least in its early form, has been completed and will now be moving towards the soon-to-be war zone near the Onyx Watch border. And considering that I do plan to attack the Onyx Watch fairly soon, I guess I'll need to upgrade this small mine into a dockyard. Or at least add a dockyard next to it, so that I do have a little base of operations there, from which I can repair new craft, resupply, and build new ones. Yeah, but for now, the White Flayers, they are still very much active. I will leave this village of High Lorham, I believe it be for now. Those are a lot of buildings actually, two executioner turrets. I guess I need some specialized unit to deal with this, something with mortars or maybe a heavy bomber. I'll see what I can come up with. So, the White Flayers have sent another Karin my way. Yeah, I guess I can deal with this one using my Air Force for now, since Task Force Jupiter is a little bit occupied at the moment, busy capturing another terrain tile. And once this has been captured, I will then move along the border here and capture everything that borders Steel Strider territory. I want this territory and all the resources And there's some hefty salvage in here. Very nice. Anyway, dealing with the Charon.
Listening.
Listening. Yep. Set up like this. Listening. Set up like this. Listening. And I think this will be over rather quickly. Here we go. Airships. Everybody, they are quite useful, quite mobile, but a little bit power hungry. I mean, hungry for engine power, that is. Not, you know. Oh boy. Not power hungry, as in a sense they crave for power to govern over anyone else. You get what I mean. Okay. I did see one torpedo there get diverted by an explosion. Yeah, looks like you are pretty much outmatched against air forces, since your torpedo armament won't do you any good here. Ha! Countered. Hard countered, in fact. Yep. And it's already gone. Goodbye. There we go. Battle finished. And
listening.
I can set up the air force so that it already occupies this terrain tile. Gotta keep this capturing streak up.
Receiving. Moving now.
I need all of this territory, including this resource zone, which seems to be the only resource zone that the White Flayers currently occupy, save for their home base, that is. That would explain the low output of units and basically the amount of territory that has been captured by the Steel Striders is enormous. They have spread out very, very far. The time has finally come. It is finally time to end the White Flayers. I have caught up to their headquarters with Task Force Jupiter, and it's now time to bring in the Sol missile cruiser, some lighter air support, and Task Force Jupiter, of course. Well, well positioned here. Let's see how we do against the Gorgon, a Tithe Hold, a Sin Eater, and a Lacerator. Yeah, let's bring in the flying forces first. Oh, that was an interesting battle. This is going to be a very interesting battle. Okay then. We have enemies in the skies. This is a Lacerator, if I am not mistaken. Heading straight for my forces. Is this a suicide unit? Yes, it seems so. There's the nuke. I was afraid of that. Anyway, next up is... Excuse me for a moment. I always have to at least take a look at the enemy. This is the Tithe Hold. I assume. Wooden construction, spinny blades, very white flare-y. You should visit a doctor fairly soon. Okay then. You missed. Well, defeated the Tithe Hold. What's next? Is it... Yes, this is the Gorgon. The leg spike clearly indicates the spawning of a high volume unit. And there we go. The Gorgon, everybody. The White Flayer's home base. Equipped with rapid fire, advanced cannons, missiles, and if it hasn't changed, there should be some torpedoes. Oh yeah. Oh wait, my airships don't have shields. Or at least not strong ones. Okay. And so, the White Flayers' base of operation, their headquarters, the Gorgon, crumbles to dust. This is most excellent. In the last episode, I was able to eliminate the Lightning Hoods, one of the more annoying factions on Nita, and now the White Flayers. But let's be honest here, it seems that the Steel Striders have done a great deal of work in terms of eliminating the White Flayers. They have reduced their territory to a very small size and deprived them of most of their resource zones. So all that was necessary was for me to swoop in, save the day, and claim the victory for me. Dead. Okay, what's left? Oh, that is a Sin Eater, apparently. Nasty little bugger. Do not get too close to my missile cruiser, that one was expensive. Good thing you missed. Or did you? It's still operational. Okay, looks like I do not have any missiles fast enough to keep up with this one. Yeah, it's definitely going for the missile cruiser again. Oh yeah, good hit from the pack there, and that's it. Ha! False idols. No, the corruption, delusions, and psychosis of the fanatical White Flayers has been put to an end. Well. I am a liberator, bringing freedom. Yes, that is what I am, definitely. Not someone who is hell-bent on conquering the whole world. Battle finished! White Flayers defeated.
Listening. Moving out. Moving out.
Okay. That was surprisingly successful.
Listening. Moving out.
Yeah, so all that's left is to basically eliminate any remaining opposition here in White Flayer territory, capture everything the White Flayers have, and see what's next.
Listening.
This went fairly well. So, and with the White Flayers defeated and another faction crossed off the list, I have to say goodbye from the Azure Seas of Nita. I am their Heidsmeister, and I hope I'll see you next time when we hopefully finally begin the crusade against the Onyx Watch. But first I have to do some restructuring of my forces. Anyway, take care and goodbye.